intentional, never failing. I know that all things are working for my good. Yeah, she's intentional, never failing. All things are working
for my good.
Cause she's intentional.
She's intentional.
Hey. And it never failing. All things are working for my good.
He's intentional.
It's never failing. All things are working. Hey, I know that all things are working for my good. Yes, they are, yeah. I can smile again, and I don't have to worry, cause it's working for me. Yeah, it's working for me. Yeah, it's working for me. Come on, sing that out, say that.
I don't have to worry, cause
it's working for me. Yeah, it's working for me.
It's working for me.
And I can hold my head up.
It's working.
Hey, get your confidence back. Sing, I don't have to worry. It's working for me. My faith is rising now.
It's working for me.
And although I can't see how,
it's working for me.
I know that he's intentional.
Can we stand for a moment, please? I am the resurrection and the life, said the Lord. He that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. And whosoever liveth and believeth in me shall never die. I know that my Redeemer liveth, and that he shall stand at the latter day upon the earth. And though after my skin worms destroy this body, yet in my flesh shall I see God, who I shall see for myself, and mine eyes shall behold, and not another. We brought nothing into this world, and it is certain that we can carry nothing out. The Lord gave, the Lord has taken away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Today we are here for the Thanksgiving service of Osmond, Byron, Walters. And on behalf of the Church of God of Prophecy here at Greenville, we extend our condolences to the immediate family and the church family, which is one and the same, because the immediate family is also the church family. We want you to know that we are praying for you. We are praying with you that God will strengthen you as you go through this difficult time. We know that it's hard. It's not easy for a mother to bury her son. But God is able. God is a God of comfort. And if you just continue to lean on his everlasting arms, then he will indeed comfort you. If you have your programs, just turn with me to the hymn, the opening hymn, As I Journey Through This Land, Singing As I Go. Let us sing and worship God together.
As I journey through this land, singing as I go. Thank you.
Eternal God, our Heavenly Father and our friend, here we are another time, Lord, before your presence. Father, we thank you for this day that you have given unto us. A new day, Lord, a day we have never seen before. Lord, even though it's a sad day, but God, we give you praise. You have gathered us in your house today, O God, for this Thanksgiving service. And Father, as we come to return thanks to you, O God, for the life that you have given us for this short period of time, God, we are glad to know that you are still God and you are still in control. Father, there are things that might happen to us that we don't like and that we don't understand, but you are still God. All praise, all glory, and all honor belongs to you because you are the God of heaven and earth. Father, as we gather today, we ask, mighty God, that your Holy Spirit will abide with us. We ask that everything will be done decently and in order. God, we ask that your presence will be in control. Father, I lift each and every one before you now. God, I pray for your peace. I pray for your comfort. I pray that your presence will go before us, God. And as we go through these proceedings, mighty God, your presence will abide with us. Father, we want to feel your presence. We want to feel your loving arms around us, even as we mourn, oh God. As we cry, Father, I pray for comfort. I pray for your peace. God, I pray that your holy presence will keep us and carry us safely through. Father, we can do nothing on our own. We can do nothing without you. But we place everything in your hands now. And God, we continue to look to you as we give you the honor, the glory, and the praise. And we tell you thanks in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Bless the Lord. You may be seated. Amen. Bless the name of Jesus. Today, as we gather for this Thanksgiving service, I know that it is difficult for all of us. No one wants to see their loved one pass away, especially at this age. But we can't argue with God. Someone said God gives life and he takes it away. We cannot tell God what to do because he is the Creator. And as we gather today, I'm just gonna ask you a few things, a few favors. I'm gonna ask us to be reminded that we are in the house of God. I just want to remind everyone that we are in the house of God. Unfortunately, it might be a very long time since some of you sit in a church building. But Osmond brought you here today. Amen. And I just want to remind you, as we gather in the house of God, I want us to be on our best behavior. I want us to be respectful to each other and to the house of God. So as we go through this program, let us just go through timely. The program is a bit lengthy, but let us be patient with each other as we go through. And as I said, let us be respectful to each other. And I'm asking you also, those who will be on the program, be respectful to time, please. So take the time that you need. The time, should I say it that way? No, I shouldn't say that. You might take 35 years. So be respectful of time and let us go through this in a timely manner. I am Pastor Alan Suarez, pastor of this local church. I have here with me my wife, Sister Jane. Most of you know her. Sister Hollis is also here. She will be working along with me today in moderating the program. And I'm very happy to see my brother, my son, our friend, Brother Jevon, on the keyboard. I'm so happy that he's here. So I don't have to do that job today. Bless the Lord. And we are in for a good time as we give God thanks for the life of this young man who has left us, as we will say, too early. But we're going to give God thanks for the life and we're going to worship God in spirit and in truth. One final thing before I go, because I will hand over the program to Sister Holiness and she will carry us through. Let us remember that when we are in the house of God, somebody asked a question, what kind of church is this? It's a Holy Ghost church. What kind of church is this? What kind of church is this? Hand clapping, foot stamping, Holy Ghost, sanctified church. So what does that mean? It's highly possible that you might feel the Spirit. It's highly possible something going to touch you that you have never felt before. And you might have to shout a hallelujah, but guess what? This is where we do it. Take your feet in the presence of God. What should you do? No, man, not like that. When you feel the presence of God, what should you do?
Hallelujah!
Shout a hallelujah to God. If the Spirit of God is upon you and you want to raise your hands and say, thank you, Jesus, and you want to say hallelujah, and you want to say glory to God, you are free to do it. Because this is what we do when we gather in the house of the Lord. God bless you. I'll hand over to Sister Holiness at this time.
Today's lesson will be taken from Psalms 90, verse 1 to 13. As it says, Lord, thou hast been our dwelling place in all generations. Thou carries them away as with a flood. They are as asleep in the morning. They are like grass which grows up.
In the morning it flows and grows up. In the evening it is cooled down. And the weather.
For we are consumed by thine anger, and by the word are we troubled.
Thou hast set our inquisites before the king or secret sins in the light of the countenance.
For all our days are passed away, and what we spend our years as a tale that is told.
The days of our years are for sure, years and ten, and it by reason of strength they be fourscore years, yet it is strength, labor, and sorrow, for it is sweet power and defiled.
Who knowest the power of thy anger, even according to thy fear, so is thy word.
So take us to number others, that we may apply our hearts unto wisdom.
Return, O Lord, how long, and let it repeat that concern thy servants. This is the word of the Lord. Good morning again. Today I'll be singing a song for my dad. to last. And here on earth, everything's different. There's an end in this.
Shall all be changed. In a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trumpet, for the trumpet shall sound, and the dead shall be raised incorruptible, and we shall be changed. For this corruptible shall put on incorruption, and this mortal must put on immortality. So when this corruptible have put on incorruption, and this mortal shall have put on immortality, then shall be brought to pass the same that is written, death is swallowed up in victory. Now death, where is thy our Lord Jesus Christ? 58 and last. Therefore, my beloved brethren, be ye steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord. For as much as ye know that your labor is not in vain in the Lord. This is the word of the Lord. We honor it by saying,
thanks be to God.
All right, so just for clarity, let me see if these persons are here so we can go through the program as quickly as possible. Amen? Is Simone Campbell and Monique Foster here? Colin Walters? Mr. Walters here? Leon Walters? Judith and Chantal Walters? And Julina Needham, is she here? Okay, so at this time, we're gonna take the selection from Simone Campbell and Monique Foster, and then we're gonna be moving into our tributes. So then we take the first and second tribute. The first tribute is done by Colin Walters, community rep, and then we take the second tribute by Leon Walters, cousin. We'll go in that order, thank you.
Thank you. family. My name is Leon Walters. Everybody probably know me as Libby. Osmond grew together. Brothers, I mean, from Pampas and Napidius, you know. Long time ago, see? It's kind of really emotional. Really, there is a lot of time. Still have to say something. Osmond, Byron, Walters, Ozzy, JT, Akazaman, do him on so much other names. But I call him Cuz. I mean, I know he's not around with us today, but I really wish he was. So much memories we had together, so much fun. Always I'm a good laugh, especially when in drink your own. I mean, all together, Shaba, Rabba, and Kaba. So anybody knows us knows, as I never used to see one without the other. I don't want to die young, nobody does, but neither should you. But he'll always be in our hearts, and God bless you. He's the Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. So rest in peace, Cuz boy. Until we meet again. Thank you.
The love of a lost one is always something that's hard to just one. And for me, from a personal perspective, it's very hard. I still honestly can't believe that Osmond is not here. You know, he was so young, in the bloom of his youth. And I'm asking the church today to pray for this family. This is a very tragic loss. He died in his room. But I'm not here today to reflect on, you know, the fact that he died young. I'm here today to say that, you know, as Kola just said, he was someone who, he was the life of anywhere he went, he was a center of attraction. He just drew people to him anywhere he was. In the Yasso and Cody over the sun, as long as in the Yasso, people just gravitated towards him. That's the type of person that he was. And I want us all to remember him in that light, in that perspective. And as I said before, it's a very hard pill to swallow. You know, we're all grieving as family members. And, you know, I don't want you to grieve too much. It's hard, it's tough. But please try to hold on the positive side of it, in that he left a mark, he left something here for us. And I want to use this opportunity today to say, and I'm going to say this clearly and loudly, people are dying. People are dying hard, people are dying fast, people are dying young, people are dying old, as one was a very young person. I think we should use this opportunity to bury some of the hatches that we have with people. Some of the bad things that we have with neighbors, with friends, some of those things, let us bury them. You know, when I came in today, I said to somebody out here today, it could have been me. I'm saying that to Jesus is not. It could have been me. It could have been any one of us. And today I'm saying, I'm going to repeat myself, I'm going to ask the church to pray for this family. They're going through a very rough time, Sister Daph. We're here for you. We're here for you both in prayer, physically, spiritually, mentally. And I just want to say, as you see your trouble, by the love of the Lord.
Mm-hmm. worship. Remember, this is easy. My missing you is a heartache that never goes away. You left us with beautiful memories. Your love is still our guide. And though we cannot see you again, you are always at our side. We only part to meet again, bro. Your wings were ready, but our hearts were not. Take no rest, bro. God saw that you were tired of this life here on earth. So he took you in his loving arms to give you rest. See you in the next life. Osmond, Byron, JT, Blue Suit, Walters. See you, bro.
Rest in peace, as rest in peace. Andrina Nenam, is that person here?
Yes.
We'll take that person at this time. Is Karen here now? All right, we're moving on. So Andrina will come at this time, then we'll move forward into our off for territory.
Lord, I want you to keep me as the apple of my eye. I run under your wings of love, right there we wanna stay. Lord, answer our prayer, Lord, and not turn your eyes from me. Family member, I want God to keep you as the apple of the eye. God, still answers prayer. Just get down on your knees. He's waiting just to hear your petition. So tell him all about your knees. When afternoon church, when our new Byron and his brother Merrick in St. Anne. Those two, when I first know Merrick, and I see Byron at times, I said, Byron, you have a brother named Merrick? And that's why those two brothers, I love them so much. Anytime they see me, because I would say, they would all be hugging and we talking and laughing. Even since I see Merrick, I said to Merrick, Merrick, remember me? And I must walk over something. Okay. And I have to do a tribute for my friend, Byron. I don't know about tomorrow. I just live from day to day. I don't borrow from its such. For it's done, made time to pray. I don't worry over future, for I know what Jesus said, and today I walk.
Oh!
tomorrow. We don't seem to understand, but we know. Do you know who holds the future? It is He who holds our hands. The program calls for the offertory hymn at this time, and we ask our ushers to get themselves in place. And as we turn your program with me to the offertory hymn, Blessed Assurance, Jesus is mine.
Blessed Assurance, Jesus is mine. Oh, what a foretaste of glory yet. Heir of salvation, purchase of blood. Oh,
may be seated. We're continuing with our tributes. And so we're going to be having a tribute that Jenny's Chambers having, representative of the Powell's family. Then we have Sheridan Davis, family from his family disorder.
All of this will come to pass. No more death, no more funeral. What a day that will be.
There is coming a day when no heartache shall come, no more life.
Take comfort. One day, all this, and we shall Jesus and all those who are faithful, we will reunite with them and worship God forever. Going through, because I have been through 2019. And Mr. Sanjay Powell is the one who take care of me. So anything I have to do this morning, I have to leave it to find myself in Manchester. Right? All right, thank you very much. I'm going to do a song for the village family. When you come to the river, on the end of day, when the lost winds of sorrow are blown, there is somebody waiting to show you the way. You don't have to cross your God.
Oh, and said, no, Miss Andy, you're uncle young enough. You're just about 34. That's my daughter's age. So I know what you are going through, but God knows everything best. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Ms. Alec and Ms. Davis. I was just skipping through the program just now, and I saw something that caught my eyes. The measure of a man. It says, not how he died, but how did he live? Not what he gained, but what did he give? These are the things that measure the worth of a man as a man, regardless of his birth. Not what was his station, but had he have a heart? And how did he play his God-given part? Was he ever ready with a word of good cheer to bring back a smile to banish a tear? Not what was his church, not what was his creed, but had he befriended those really in need? Not what did the sketch in the newspaper say, but how many were sorry when he passed away? These are the things that measure the worth of a man as a man, regardless of his birth. And so I just wanted to share that with us today. It's not how we die, but it's how we live. It's not all about how we die, but it's how we live. But how we die is important also, amen? For if you die without Christ, then hell will be your portion. I understand that Karen is here. It's not for me to go back, but I'm going to ask her to come. If you're going to do a song, please do one verse of the song, the chorus. Miss Karen, Manticure this time.
So good, I can't complain. When I ask God, give the strength to rise again. When I know, oh Lord, the struggle. Oh, I listen, yes, I
you sweeter all the time. Praise God. Can we worship the Lord?
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. We are continuing with our program. At this time, we're going to be having the remembrance. This will be done by Shanika Powell Morgan, niece. And then we'll take the floral tribute. After the floral tribute, then we'll have the eulogy, which will be done by Eula Stevens, aunt. Please come in that order.
For Osmond. As I share this remembrance on behalf of Osmond Byron Waters, as I listened to Leon speak earlier, I chuckled because similarly to Leon, Osmond and I grew up together. Never called him Uncle Osmond because we're the same age. We were born the same year. So there was never a time when I have said Uncle Osmond. He was always Aziz. Of course, though, he went out of his way to call me niece, as a reminder that he's older than me. Of course, that got him lots of old eyes. Ozzy, I remember Ozzy in a happy way. Ozzy was a son, a brother, a father, husband, uncle, granduncle, cousin, brother-in-law, and friend. It's hard to remember Osmond without a smile on your face. He had the heart that cared completely. He had the smile that brought so much pleasure. He had the love that brought joy beyond measure. When I think of Osmond, a few words come to mind. Food, family, friends, fun, and not necessarily in that order. Any day of the week. As I share, I also share on behalf of Chantel, the sister who was closest in age to Osmond. And she helped me a lot to write this remembrance because of how close they were and also because she wasn't able to be here. So Chantel shared that Osmond came to look for her, and this is them being overseas. Chantel is married, living with her husband. And Osmond came to look for them. And she said she left, they left and went on the road, she and her husband. And she said when she came back, Osmond cooked one big pot of pea soup. This pot is the pot that they normally use for family get together. This is not no regular house pot. So Chantel said, Ozzy, where you find this pot? How you know which pot the pot there? He said he had come to the house a long, long time before that, and they had shown him the pot down in the basement. So when he decided to cook up a storm, that's the pot he went for. Chantel said it was so much soup, but Osmond was adamant that they're going to drink it off that night. And she said throughout the night, they chat and Osmond constantly in at the soup pot, in at the soup pot. And she said up until midnight, as he said, since we are done, you know, we are done. It. And so said, so done, mind you. This pea soup was alongside curry turkey neck and white rice. Right? All of that Osmond cooked in their absence. Ozzy loved to eat. On my side of the family, we looked forward to Osmond and Boye. For those who know, Boye is Osmond's youngest brother. We looked forward to them coming to our house on Sunday. Why? Because on a Sunday, we were told that we must eat off our dinner. We had to show the plate to mommy. And for some reason, we could never master this feat. None of my, well, my brother could, who is the one with the funeral home, but my sister, my other two sisters, we couldn't quite master that feat. But when Osmond and Boye roll up, we make sure that we sit down beside them, and they helped us to eat, especially Samantha. She would love to show mommy the clean plate. Mommy, I finished, thanks to Osmond. Osmond not only loved to eat, he also loved to cook. Ozzy could cook everything. He loved his curry, he loved his fish, he loved his turkey neck, and he could cook everything. I remember when we went for Grandma's birthday down in St. Anne. Everybody who knows Grandma knows she is the chef. But the party was in St. Anne, at the beach. And when we got down there, Osmond had cooked everything. Osmond called me and said, Nisi, carry the vegetables somewhere where they carry from a family reunion. I said, what are you talking about? He said, the veggie lasagna. So I'm like, we're having a party. Why do I need to bring veggie lasagna with all of your Trenton and all of these things that you have down there? He said, come Nisi, bring the veggie something, man. Come balance out the thing. For Chantal's wedding, Osmond cooked everything before they even woke up. For his birthday that just went March 2, Osmond cooked everything before 9 o'clock the morning. At 9 a.m., he had everything on display. All ready, fried fish, rice and peas, curry, turkey neck, in lovely Trenton, and everything was done because Osmond was quite happy to get up before day and start the cooking. As you know, Osmond came from a big family. With 12 siblings, you know he had an energetic childhood. And it was among these brothers and sisters that Osmond developed his winsome personality. And up to the Asia, make two kind of prank people. Chantal and Judith shared how they used to have to wash for Osmond and Boye. And they said they don't know if it's because of them having to wash. Why they dirty the clothes go and they dirty them come. So one particular day they were washing. And of course, Ozzy was there, a babe, couldn't have to wash the clothes, a babe. And he was going on and on. And so Boye, of course, the youngest brother, was tagging along. And Chantal said it just so happened that Grandma appeared. And when Grandma heard them and the gimmick that they were going on with, Grandma assigned them their own bath pan. And she said, take out their clothes and put them over this. And they packed their clothes in their bath pan. And Chantal said that was it. From that, they had to wash their own clothes. Because Grandma caught them red-handed. Osmond always behaved like the older brother. He was always looking out for his sisters, always setting up them with job opportunities, always trying to get them help. Even I remember when Chantal was working in St. Anne with where Osmond also worked. And even when Osmond was on morning shift, he would make sure that in the evenings he never let Chantal to go home. And when he was on evening shift, he would send his colleagues to go make sure that Chantal gets home in the night. Ozzy was always checking in. Always, walk on me dog.
Yes.
Where are you with? Uncle G.
Yes.
That was Ozzy. Osmond was an extraordinary father. Always checking in on his kids. His dream was for them to be under the same roof. Each time I remember him coming to Jamaica, he would gather them together. He took them to my house, he took them to Grandma. I remember the last time when he had them all together. They didn't plan to overnight at Grandma. But when he got there, he decided to stay. And of course, the kids weren't prepared. But Daddy Extraordinaire went shopping. And he brought the toothbrushes, and he bought the rags, and everything that they needed, just to overnight. I remember when we were in St. Anne, and all the kids were there, and we were going to the beach, and Hannah's mother had sent Hannah with her backpack. And Osmond said, Hannah have everything, Hannah being his only daughter. So we were like, yes, and mother, is our mother send her things, everything must be there. He said, no, up in the make me see. She have blouse, she have shorts, we can be probably filling her one of Chris shorts. She have shoes, we come back, wear a bikini. And that was Osmond searching out the bag and making sure that everything was in there for Hannah. Osmond could call on any of his sisters to look out for any of his kids. He knew he could depend on them. Osmond loved family. I remember when he migrated and he lived with his wife and his stepchildren, and I remember seeing Osmond picture in Christmas pajama. And I'm like, is that Osmond? But yes, he loved family. And wherever that family was, whether he was in Jamaica, he was overseas, he blended right in and he did what he needed to do. Osmond neat and tidy can done. When you saw Osmond's bed, not a crease in the bed. Every morning bed spread, neat and clean. Then we get to the fun. Osmond loved partying, loved music, loved dancing, loving liquor, loved football. And of course, based on the program you can see, he loved take picture. Right? So this was Osmond. He was the vibes of the party. He was the life of the party. Osmond, well, I saw when he went overseas. Sorry. I saw when Osmond went overseas and he went to visit again his sister and her husband. And in the basement they had a sound system. And when you saw Osmond on the sound system, you couldn't believe he wasn't a DJ by birth. Osmond made friends easily. When he migrated, I remember Osmond reaching out to me and Ozzy said, niece, we need your help. And I said, what? He said, we need to learn Spanish. He said, what? So I said, yes, we need to learn Spanish. You don't speak Spanish? So I said, well, I speak French. I speak a little Spanish. He's like, no, man, we need to learn some Spanish. What the fastest way for me to learn some Spanish? So I said, why do you need to learn Spanish? He said, my co-workers, them, and I saw Mexican, and we need to talk to them. So I said to him, the best way to learn Spanish is to talk to your co-workers. I said, you are in this situation, so you're going to learn Spanish quickly. Not too long after that, Ozzy sent me voice note in a Spanish. He said, uncle, please send me even Spanish. He said, uncle, no. We cannot. But Osmond, he did. And he learned enough to communicate with his co-workers, because that was Osmond. It was all about making friends. Ozzy friends them rate him. Ozzy family rate him. Osmond loved connecting. He took flights as needed when he migrated to see friends in New York, friends in Michigan. Of course, he had lots of friends in Florida and other states. He traveled with his family just to connect. Ozzy, full of lyrics. Had a way with women. Full of lyrics. And so Boye shared that one particular, this was when Ozzy was younger and they were helping grandma, when grandma used to sell in the market. And Boye shared one memory. He said, when they were in the market and it was Saturday night and they were ready to go home. And they looked, grandma had a bag of string bean, a whole crocus bag full of string bean. And she said, I'm going to carry home and get a pig because by Monday it was spoiled. And so Ozzy said, no, mommy, bag up here and give it. So grandma bagged it up and she gave Ozzy and Boye the string bean. And Boye said, Osmond sell all the string bean by convincing the woman that it would help a particular body part to grow big. I didn't say anything. Osmond loved perfume, loved loving colors, and Osmond loved loving shoes. Loving shoes, Thames Nike Jordan, Ozzy, dress up, match up. That was Osmond. Osmond would buy a pair of shoes and then go shopping the whole 2 days to find the shirt to match. That was Osmond. Osmond believed that life was for living, and he lived a full life. If I were to make up an acrostic with his name, it would read, O is for outstanding, S is for special, M is for memorable, O is for open-hearted, N is for nice and neat, D is for determined. Osmond was full of life. He interacted with all his siblings making all of them feel as if they were the favorite. I'm sure if I ask Judith now, she thinks she's the favorite sister. And so does Susan. And it was for the same reason that I thought I was the favorite niece, until I realized I didn't call everybody favorite niece. But that was Osmond, full of love, connections, interactions. And so as we are here today, we have to remember Osmond with a smile. He's gone, and we say he's gone too soon, but he lived. He lived. Osmond believed that life was for living. And so as we are here, family, friends, Coco, siblings, mommy, Judith, Susan, Stacy, Ian, Clive, Danny, Boye, Chantel, where you are, Mary. As you are here, Ian, remember the life that your brother lived, Clive. And remember him with a smile. I leave this poem with us. When I come to the end of the road, and the sun has set for me, I want no rights in a gloom-filled room. Why cry for a soul set free? Miss me a little, but not for long, and not with your head bowed low. Remember the love that we once shared. Miss me, but let me go. For this is a journey we all must take, and each must go alone. It's all a part of the master plan, a step on the road to home. When you are lonely and sick at heart, go to the friends we know. Laugh at all the things we used to. Miss me, but let me go. So let us remember Osmond in a happy way.
Bye. by his niece who just came and did the remembrance, so I'm reading it on her behalf. Osmond Byron Walters, affectionately called Azzy, was born on Wednesday, March 2, 1988, at the Mandeville Regional Hospital. He was the 13th child of Ivan and Daphne Walters and their 8th son. Osmond spent his formative years in Litchfield, where he attended the Bethany All-Age School, successfully passing the GSAT exam. Saw him gaining a spot at Christiana High School, where he developed a love for the world of automobiles, and everything car related. It was also during these years that he developed the outstanding personality and his social skills, for which he is well known. Osmond loved giving jokes, making jokes and having a good time in general. He was always up to some gimmick or other, from teasing his siblings to playing practical jokes or taking nieces and nephews on wild adventurous rides or rides on hand cart. Osmond was quite character. With a passion for the auto world, Osmond went to further his studies at the German Automotive School in Kingston. While there, he stayed with his beloved family in Ferry and made countless connections. He was even a part of a dance group there, and those who knew Osmond well know that dance made up his DNA. He loved a good party and he had all the skills to make it happen. I would just add that he was an excellent father. As we think about Father's Day tomorrow, I just put in that he was an excellent father and a gentle giant. He was always great with not only his biological kids, but also to those of his siblings and whoever else may be in his space at a particular point in time. When they were younger, one could see him jockey riding them, either over his back, either on his back or over his neck, across the rough terrain from his mom's house to his grandma's house in Richmond. Osmond was a jack of all trades and he was a hustler. From assisting his mother with selling goods in the market to working at a car wash on construction sites, and in other locations. Osmond was all about living. He was an auto mechanic. He was an auto mechanic and spent the greater part of his adult life working for Naranda Bauxite and Stewart Limited in St. Anne's. Even though Osmond was now living in St. Anne, his family in Litchfield never had time to miss him. Osmond journeyed to Manchester for every event, every celebration, and any mission he could come up with. He was blessed. He loved his family. And he was all about making and maintaining connections. He was blessed with 4 children, Romaine, Oren, Otain, Christopher, and Hannah, who were prophet died. He was most alive when all his children were around him. And every opportunity he had to spend time with them, he took it. Osmond lived to make others happy and men and women alike were drawn to Osmond, as Lisa just said. One such woman was Nioka Clay, who snatched Osmond from the eligible bachelor's market on August 11, 2018, when they were in St. Anne. In 2020, Osmond migrated to Florida to live with his wife and family. He worked for Johnson Brothers Construction, but spent every free moment with his family and friends. Osmond did not think twice about traveling to Michigan to spend time with his sister Chantal and her husband, or with friends and family as far as New York. Wherever Osmond went, he brought the vibes with him and this made people love him without even thinking about it. As family and friends shared their favorite memories of Osmond, a few things stood out. He feared God and he was never without a Bible. He loved pork and soup and he was a master chef. He loved music, partying and dancing. He loved the family and he lived for his children. He was jovial and noisy. He was the life of the party. He knew how to make a big entrance. Never a dull moment around Osmond. And Kimberly just reminded me while we were sitting there that he spent most of his summer holidays at our home. And we can remember one in particular when he came. I think it's probably the last time he came, or the second to last time he came. He was a teenager and my son here was also a teenager. They are close in age. And I remember at that time they were going to the eating phase. I could hardly eat anything that is put on the table. My son would wipe it off before you can wink your eye. And so when Osmond came that holiday, I don't usually share food. Sister Daphne is share of the family. I can't share at all. So I just cook and I put the things in servants and everybody help themselves. So I put the food on the table and we said grace. And Osmond bent down his head like this and he got his plate and he started sharing, helping himself. And we said, okay. Somehow we had the private joke to say, let us see whether he or Carson would win the eating contest. They had an unofficial eating contest. And Osmond just kept going and going. And each time his plate emptied, he just kept going and going. When I looked at Carson just had to back off himself. And so we all watched until that Osmond knocked out. He's not even aware that we were watching him. He just kept eating. And poor Carson left in the dark. And when he was finished, the verb that he sat upon the rock is buried. And we had to clap it because he had Carson was no match for him at all. That's not one for us. He was kind, caring, and passionate about living and giving. He was energetic and he breathed positive vibes. He never entertained negativity. He had a passion for traveling, and long before he even got a passport, he always wanted to travel the world. Above all, Osmond believed in family, faith, hard work, independence, and community. We had him for only 35 years, which seemed a brief moment, but Osmond was busy making sure that he was just out there. He not just counted the years, but made the years count. He lives to mourn. He leaves to mourn his wife, Naoka. Naoka Clay Waters, children, Romaine, Kane, Christopher, and Anna. Stepchildren, Dominique, Destiny, Rashad, and Marie, and Maria. Mother, Daphne Waters, grandmother, Lena Foley. Siblings, Carol, Christine, Sonia, Donovan, Ian, Clive, Merrick, Suzanne, Stacy, Judith, Chantal, Kemar, 11 nieces, 14 nephews, 12 grandchildren, and
she was just checking to see if he was listening.
I thought about myself. 12 grandnieces and grandnephews, aunties, uncles, and other relatives and friends. He will be sadly missed by all of us, but we do hope that he rests in peace and life perpetual shine upon him. There's a point that I don't really have time to post it. I'll post it on the you want to. Alright, there's a point, so
okay, here goes the poem. Although your heart may be broken, there's no need to weep for me. I'm in a wonderful place now where I'm happy and so carefree. I had to go, but I've left behind good memories to comfort you. Concentrate on the best times we had and try not to feel so blue. For one day we'll be together again to laugh and sing and play. You'll be so glad to see me again.
Welcome to Concerts Early in the Afternoon. Today we're here to celebrate the life of Mr. Walters, the uncle of our friend and colleague Mr. Powell. However, he would have asked me to do a selection today, but the saxophonist would have already gone today. Well, yeah, he requested something else.
Too many miles behind me. Too many trials they are through. He has crossed
Disciples, first of all, beware of
the leaven of the Pharisees, which is hypocrisy. For there is nothing covered that shall not be revealed, neither hid that shall not be known. Therefore, whatsoever ye have spoken in darkness shall be heard in the light, and that which ye have spoken in the ears, in the closets, shall be proclaimed upon the housetop. I say unto you, my friends, be not afraid of them that kill the body, and after that have no more that they can do. But I will forewarn you whom he shall fear. Fear him which after he hath killed hath power to cast into hell. Yea, I say unto you, fear him. Bless the Lord. Today we are mourning Osmond's death. And it's a rather sad thing to see a young man pass this life at such a tender age. 45 is when you're getting ready to live. You know, I reached my half century the other day and I feel like my life just stopped. So I can imagine this is a very young age to die. But the Word of God reminds us that we should be careful of dying without Christ. And that's the message I want to get across to us today. Be careful of dying without Christ. I say to us that I have a history here, and it's rather amazing, because this program tells us that, and the eulogy tells us that Osmond was born in 1988. I came here in 1991. And of course I remember the little boy and a lot of other young children were here, all grown up now. Well, of course there are still others that's coming on the scene. But I remember Osmond as a little boy in church. Because of course, Mama Coley being the matriarch, Sister Walters being the daughter, and all the children, church. That's where you go. You go to church. Amen. Right? So in the 80s and 90s, church. Young people go to church. Yes. And when I came here, we had a lot of young people. Because that's what used to happen. Unfortunately, we have to put it in the past. But that's what used to happen. People grow up and people make their decisions. And you are free to do what you want to do because you're big, you're an adult. But don't fear the one who can only kill the body. Fear the one who, after you die, your soul and your body go to hell. Be careful of the man who will allow you to go to hell. Which is not his plan. Well, I shouldn't say man allow you to go to hell, because the fact is you allow yourself to go to hell. Because the plan of the man, Jesus Christ, is for all to come to repentance. I've heard that for a while. I'm coming back to it in a while. I go to verse 30. Still at St. Luke chapter 12. It said, and one of the company said unto him, Master, speak to my brother that he divide the inheritance with me. And he said unto him, Man, who made me a judge or a divider over you? And he said unto them, Take heed and beware of covetousness, for a man's life consisteth not in the abundance of the things which he possesseth. Continuing, verse 16, And he spake a parable unto them, saying, The ground of a rich man brought forth plentifully. And he thought within himself, saying, What shall I do? Because I have no room where to bestow my fruits. And he said, This will I do. I will pull down my barns and build greater. And here will I bestow all of my fruits and my goods. And I will say to my soul, Soul, thou hast much goods laid up for many years. Take thine ease. Eat. Drink. And thing required of thee? Then who shall those things be which thou hast provided? For is he, so is he that layeth up treasure for himself, and is not rich towards God. I'm going to speak to my young people for a while. For those who are Osmond age and little younger and a little older, life can be good. Life can be nice. Life is filled with all kind of things these days for us to enjoy. And boy, you know, I say to people all the time that I am glad for when God saved me. Because see, before I got saved, I had a desire, or I had many desires, to do many things that I could not afford to do. And God saved me while I was poor and broke and had nothing. After I got a little thing and I can afford to have fun, I realized that I'm a child of God. So that kind of fun I have to deny myself of. So here was a young man who said, I have a whole lot. So I am going to expand my barn. Can I build it home in the modern day time? I'm going to lift down this little house that I have. Because it is too small. I'm going to get a bigger bathroom. Because I want jacuzzi. I want a rain shower. I want it to be nice and big. But God, the Creator, hallelujah, the man who made you and breathed breath into you, said, thou fool, tonight you shall die. So who's gonna live in your house? Who's gonna enjoy your jacuzzi? Who's gonna bask in your king-size bed? What am I saying to you today? Never live your life without Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. We are all brought to church as children. I dedicate hundreds of children in this church, and many of them go on the street. I hear me, if you live your life without Jesus and die without him, you're going to a devil's hell. And it doesn't matter what anybody tell you, enjoy your life. The wise man Solomon tell you, enjoy your youth. And then he said, all of this is vanity and vexation of spirit. Brothers and sisters, it's time for us to understand that our mighty God still sits on the throne. Hallelujah. And when our mother and our grandmother used to carry us to church, it's because they knew and they understood the importance of getting to know Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. I know this is not the kind of word that you are expected to hear. But hear me, you don't have to be my friend after today. Because if I don't tell you what God wants you to hear, the blood is going to be at my shoulder. Hear me, people of God, this world has gone too wild. Our young people have gone too wild. Too much rum, too much ganja smoking, too much party. You need Jesus Christ. Jesus. Never say as man of Jesus. Never live your life without Jesus.
Lord Jesus Christ is between God and man. So I don't know the relationship that Osmond had with Jesus. I know that he was a church boy, good church boy, think that they taught him in Sunday school. I remember when Osmond stood here as a candidate. Osmond and Orlando. Some of you remember that. Two cousins, I felt so good. Seeing the young boys in their black pants and white shirts standing right here in this very church. Now he's lying on his back in a glass casket. Don't live without Jesus. It don't go down too well. I don't know some too good. But hear me, I don't want to have to dedicate you, baptize you, and then bury you without Jesus. How can you walk in church as a baby? How can you get to know Jesus as a teenager? And then you die before you're 50 and lose weight. The devil is a liar. The devil won't trick you. The devil won't carry you ahead. But to lead you to hell. God, someone not hear that. God, to carry you ahead. I have been a church boy for most of my life. I have known Jesus since 1991. And he turned my life around. He gave me everything that I need. Because my God shall supply all my needs according to his riches and glory. Young people, old people, stop living like a fool. Yes. Amen. And he kind of fool you. It's the word of God. Amen. It's the word of God. Amen. Because when you fill up yourself for all the things and think that everything's a nice and you can do other things, the word of God say you're a fool. Amen. What does it profit a man to gain the whole world and lose his soul?
From sin, yeah. Not for
life for us to enjoy.
Yes.
But for God's sake, don't do it without God.
Amen.
Don't leave him out in your celebration.
Amen.
When you travel and you go far and you enjoy yourself and you come home, find back your church.
Yes.
Get back to where it started. Because if you did not have such a good start, you would never reach where you are. Don't forsake your God. Don't forsake your roots. Because all that will happen to you is that you will die and go to hell. Nothing else to it. So when you enjoy your life like this young man in the scripture, God said, this is how it is. When you lay up treasures for yourself and not reach towards God. So when you decide to enjoy yourself, enjoy it with God.
Yes.
Let God be pleased at your celebration.
Yes.
Let God be a part of whatever celebration you're having. Let God be a part of whatever you are doing. Never leave him out of it. Because here, brothers and sisters, we cannot change what God says. When we wander far from him, when we drift from the church and drift away from righteousness, God still remains God. God still stands waiting. He said, I stand at the door and knock. And if any man will open unto me, I will come in. He's still calling. He's still beckoning to you. And he's saying, repent, change your ways. He's still calling. And he will never stop. Because he's that kind of God. His mercies endure forever. He's a merciful God. Hallelujah. He never changes. Verse 31 said, rather seek ye the kingdom of God, and all these things shall be added unto you. Stop worrying about what you don't have. Seek the kingdom of God, and God will take care of you. So as I close, I remind you, never live your life without Jesus. And can I just say something else to you? Stop letting the devil fool you and tell you that you are okay. Because you're not. And don't get excited by those preachers who, when you're dead, they pray for Mother Mary, took you up for him. Because it's not going to work. There's no repentance in the grave. That's a decision you have to make for yourself. That is something that you have to do for yourself. Mother Mary can't do it for you. So don't let anybody have any nice words to say about you. I'm pretty tough after you pass this life. Somebody said, before you die, seek the Lord. Seek the Lord while he may be found. Call upon him while he's near. That's what God wants for us. And my young people, as I said many times already, enjoy your life. Because life has a whole lot of fun. I am enjoying my life. I have a beautiful wife. I have a beautiful family. And I enjoy my life. But I don't leave out Jesus. Because he's the source of my life. My life belongs to him. And you two who don't know him, you can do this thing. Give your life in his hands. And I will do it for you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Father, we give you glory, we give you honor, we give you praise. God, I thank you for your anointing today. I thank you for your words. God, I thank you that your people heard your words. And Father, I know that even now someone is thinking about the word. And God, I pray that you will rest with them. And there will never be a peace of God until they make a decision to follow you as Lord and as Savior. God, I am glad to know that you are the one who said you came to seek and to save that which was lost. And God, all we can do is to impart your words. But you are the one who will save. And I ask you now, Lord, to save those who are in sin before it's too late. Turn your lights on, Almighty God, as we look to you now, and we tell you thanks.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Blessed be the name of the Lord. God bless you, people of God. We're going to be taking the prayer for the glory family at this time. We're not yet over, so please don't leave just yet. Just give us a few more minutes. I'm going to be asking the church to stand while the family members remain seated. And I'll be doing the prayer for the bereaved family. So family members remain seated, and I'm going to ask the congregation to stand. Stand out as you sit in reverence to God. Just bow your heads as I pray. Heavenly Father, one more time as we enter your presence, God, we thank you for this time. Oh God, we thank you for bringing us safely through this program. And oh God, I present the family members of the deceased before you at this time. God, we are going through a difficult time. The family is hurting. They are in so much pain. Oh God, because of the death of this young man. But God, we know that you are a God of comfort. And we ask you at this time, mighty God, that you will wrap your loving arms around them. God, we ask that you will comfort them and you will help them, that they will feel your presence. God, I lift Sister Daphne before you at this time. Father, I know it's difficult for any mother to bear their son. But God, I ask that you will overshadow her. You will undergird her, oh God, with your love at this time. You will wrap her in your loving arms, oh God, and she will know that you are there. Help her never to feel alone, oh God, but to always know that your presence is right by her side. Father, I pray for all the brothers, all the sisters at this time. I pray especially for the children, oh God, for the wife. God, I pray that you will comfort them. I pray that you will be with them, mighty God. Carry them through, Lord, as they go through this dark time. Mighty God, you promise that you will be by their sides. Father, I pray for the extended family. I pray for love, I pray for unity, I pray for togetherness. God, if there is anyone or anything, oh God, that might cause division, we come against it now in the name of Jesus. And God, I pray that they will stand together, they will stand united, they will stand as one, mighty God, as they continue to seek you for direction. Have your way with them, dear Lord. Cover them under your blood, and let your presence abide with them continually. Father, as we get ready to leave from here, oh God, to move over to Litchfield, I pray for your protection. I pray you'll watch over us. I pray you'll carry us safely on our way. Oh God, be with us throughout the rest of these proceedings. And Father, we'll continue to give you the honor, the glory, and the praise. Hear us now, I pray, as we wait upon you and we tell you thanks. In Jesus' name. Amen. Bless the Lord. Okay, I'm going to ask the pallbearers to come at this time. And let's get ready to exit as we do our reception again. As you take up your position, can we just be orderly, please? Can we just wait a few more minutes and just let's finish this properly, please? Can we stand as we do the hymn? There is a land beyond the river that we call the sweet forever, and we only reach that shore by faith's decree. As you take up your position, we're going to do the first verse and the chorus, and then we are going to march out. The clergy will go first, followed by the casket, then the family members, and then the rest of the congregation. So can we stand as we do the hymn together? There is a land beyond the river.
There is a land beyond the river that we call the sweet forever, and we only reach that shore by faith's decree.
never, this nobody never, kill nobody never, see nobody with them things, and traffic grab it you, give away your last all when you no have it yet, I saw your heart still, always, so when that innocent life pass, the one them we get take when I need dark, them say, things we have you no big question the Lord, but this made me a fiat, so God, where do angels go when they die, is there heaven in the sky? Where nobody knows. Cause rain fall when the angels cry. There a place beyond their eyes. Where nobody knows. Oh, red angels go when they die. There a heaven in the sky. Nobody knows. Cause rain fall. To the 4 year old, the billions of the devil. Me navigate and another day. Mother cry over the body, not a piece. Yeah, I will catch you there when me ask fame. Why go up and out to Chave and Martin? Me big brother gone, it make me heart wait. Me heart bleed, them lift me heart sin. Where do angels go when they die? Is there a heaven in the sky where nobody knows?
And the road is gone up yonder, I'll be there. When the road is gone up yonder, 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 I'll be there.
Can we praise the Lord?
Yes, the Lord.
Amen. Man that is born of a woman hath but a short time to live, and is full of misery. He cometh up and is cut down. Like a flower, he fleeth as it were a shadow, and never continueth in one state. In the midst of life, we are in debt. Of whom may we seek comfort? But of thee, O Lord, who for our sins are justly displeased. Yet, O Lord God, most holy, O Lord, most mighty, O holy and merciful Savior, deliver us not into the bitter pains of eternal death. Thou knowest, Lord, the secrets of our hearts. Shut not thy merciful ears to our prayer, but spare us. Lord, most holy, O God, most mighty, O holy and merciful Savior, thou most worthy, judge eternal. Suffer us not at our last hour for any pain of death to fall from thee.
Cameraman, just step back a little bit for me, alright?
For as much as it has pleased Almighty God in His wise providence to take out of this world the soul of our deceased brother. We therefore commit his body to the ground. Earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust. Whereby he is able to subdue all things unto himself. May his soul rest in peace, and may light perpetually shine upon him. We'll continue singing.
Oh, red angels go when they die. Is there a heaven in the sky? Nobody knows. Cause rain fall when the angels cry. Is there a place beyond their eyes? Nobody knows.